Yes. Let's do the next stanza. He should be snarling. Yes, sorry. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the water pole where plump deer pass. It means the tiger should have been in the forest where he will hide himself with the long grass and wait near the water body so that the deer may come there for drinking water and he can make them his food. So let's do its questions. First question can be, name the poem and the poet. This is clear to you? I have already told you name of the poem and the poet and how to write. Next question is, who is lurking in shadow? So the students, who is lurking in the shadow? He should be lurking in shadow. Who is he here? He is the tiger. So you will write, the tiger should be lurking in shadow. Next question can be, how should he walk through grass? And you know the answer is given, sliding through long grass. So the question is, how should he walk through grass? Answer will be, he should be sliding through grass. Who passes near the water pole where plump deer pass? So who pass? The deer, the fat, the plump deer pass through the water hole. Next question can be, who does he in the stanza refer to? So the students, you will have to be very careful when this type of question is asked, because you know he is given for the tiger, but in this poem he is used for the tiger when he is in the cage, then when he is in the forest. So you will have to write the answer according to the stanza, whatever is given. And who is he? It means the tiger is in the forest or he is in the cage. You will have to answer accordingly. Suppose for the second stanza, he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the water pole where plump deer pass. For this stanza, if this question comes, that who is he? Who does he refer to? Here he is in the jungle. So your answer will be, he in the given stanza is the tiger in the forest. Next question can be, why would he be lurking in shadow? And your answer will be, he should be lurking in shadow to hide himself. Next question can be, what does he hope to find there? Use wahan kya milne ki umeed hai? He hopes to find his prey there. P-R-E-Y, prey. Or you can answer, he hopes to find deer for his food there. Or you can answer, he hopes to find his food there. Clear? Next, third stanza, he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws terrorizing the village. It means the tiger, if in the forest, he must be terrorizing the people who live at the jungle's edge. The houses, he will be near the houses that are built at the jungle's edge. And there, with his white fangs and his claws, he will terrorize the people. So, the question can be, why do you think he should be snarling around houses? So, the answer can be, he should be snarling around houses to terrorize the people. Next question can be, what does he do while moving at the jungle's edge? What does he do while moving at the jungle's edge? So the question can be, he shows his white fangs and his claws as he growls and moves along the jungle's edge. Next question can be, how do the people feel and why? How do the people feel and why? The answer will be, the people feel terrified because they can hear the tiger snarling around their houses. And one more question can be from this is, yes, why does he look at the houses at the jungle's edge? The answer can be, he can look at the houses at the jungle's edge because he hopes to find his food there also. Next stanza is, but he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stroking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Here, the question can be, who does he refer to in the stanza? The same question is there, but the answer will be different. Now, he is locked in a concrete cell. So, who does he refer to? The answer will be, he refers to the tiger in the cage, or he refers to the tiger in the zoo. Next question is, why is he locked? Why is he locked? He is locked in a concrete cell. Why? He is locked so that he do not escape. Next question can be, explain. Stalking the length of his cage. Stalking the length of his cage. You have to explain this. The explanation of this is, because the cage is very small, so he cannot jump there. He cannot have a long walk. So he just takes a few steps of his cage, and that is why he walks slowly. Next, why is he ignoring visitors? Ignoring visitor. Why does he ignore visitors? Because daily so many people come to visit him, so it has become a daily routine. That is why he does not look at them with any interest. That is why he ignores them. The last stanza, he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. It means the last voice that he hears is that of the car that is going near the zoo, and his eyes are brilliant. With his brilliant eyes, he looks at the brilliant stars. Perhaps he wants to ask the goat why he is locked in the cage here. So the question can be, who does he in these lines refer to? Again, he is in the cage. So the answer will be, he refers to the tiger in the zoo. Next question can be, what last voice does he hear at night? And the answer will be, the last voice that he hears at night is that of the patrolling cars. The last question, what does he stare at? Can you tell why? What does he stare at? He stares at the brilliant stars. And answer, can you tell why? Perhaps he wants to ask God why he is locked here in the cage. I hope the poem is quite clear to you. Still, if you feel any doubt, you can ask me. Okay? Thank you.